Hello everybody. Today we will be talking about trabeculectomy and its modifications. I am Dr. Kamala and the head of glaucoma services at Shankarai Hospital, Shimoga. So let me take you through the instruments that are required for trabeculectomy. So the first thing which is required is the drape cutting scissor, where we cut the drape, looks like a normal scissor. The next thing what is required is a speculum. So there are two types of speculums which can be used. One is a normal wire speculum which is there, and this particular speculum is called as the Irvine eye speculum. So if you see carefully, there are a lot of loose parts which are available, and the screw can be tightened and the eyeball can be fixed nicely into the socket. So when you use this speculum, you can avoid the bridle suture, that is the superior rectus sutures can be avoided in most of the cases where you use the Irvine eye speculum. So the next step in trabeculectomy is that you have to do the peritomy. So for doing the peritomy, you need a Hoskin's forceps, which is the tooth forceps, and it fixes the globe, and you need a conjunctival scissor. It is also called as the Westrose conjunctival scissors. The next step in trabeculectomy is doing a flap. So you need either a blade breaker with which you can fix onto the Raja blade and do the flap, or the Bart Parker handle with on which you can fix the 11 number blade and do the flap. So the next step in trabeculectomy is the use of mitomycin C. So I will describe the mitomycin C in detail when we see the surgical video. So it comes in a powder form which has to be reconstituted and diluted according to the need of the case. So in the next step, we do the ostium, where or the sclerostomy. We use a Kelly sponge. This is how the Kelly sponge looks like. It has a punching mechanism with which the sclera, a bite of the sclera can be cut. So the next step is doing the PI or the iridectomy, for which you need the iris forceps, which is a small bent and a toothed forceps, so it can hold the iris well under the sclerostomy ostium, and the vanus is used to cut the iris. The next step is to push the iris, that is the prolapsing iris, back into the anterior chamber, for which we use a iris repositor. So once the PI is done, then if you have to do the cataract extraction, we will need the following instruments for cataract surgery, that is the Vectis, the Sinsky hook, the Simco for cortical aspiration, and the McPherson forceps for the IOL insertion. So these are the instruments which are required for the cataract surgery. Now after all this is done, we have to suture the flap. The flap is sutured with a 10-0 nylon. And the suturing instruments which are required are the straight forceps, a curved forceps, and the needle holder. So the flap is sutured with 10-0 nylon. The same can be used for conjunctiva, or the conjunctiva can be sutured with a 8-0 vicryl as well. Now the other things which are required, which may be used, is the collagen. This is a collagen matrix which is used for tissue repair. So this can be used instead of mitomycin C. It comes in a packing like this, and the box inside has a collagen matrix which is could be circular or square in shape. Now I'll take you through the surgical video of trabeculectomy. So as I told you, the first step is doing the peritomy using the conjunctival scissors and the Hoskin's forceps. The next step is the use of bipolar cautery. So the bleeders are cauterized using a bipolar cautery so that there is no bleeding into the AC or while doing the flap. Now the flap can be cut, as I told, with a blade holder or a blade breaker with a Raja blade, or you can use a BP handle with a 11 number blade. So once the outline of the flap is made, need to dissect the apex of the flap. Now the flap can be either triangular or rectangular flap depending upon the comfort of the surgeon. So So once the apex is dissected, then you can work through the separation of the scleral fibers using a 15 number plate, which is attached to a BP handle, that is a Bart Parker handle. So you have to gently dissect the scleral fibers till the blue line, that is the limbus. You need to slowly dissect into the limbus, taking utmost care that you don't enter into the AC or you don't go deeper into the sclera to avoid any inadvertent premature entry or damage to the ciliary body. So once that is done, at this stage we need to apply the mitomycin C. So mitomycin C can be applied following the Moore flow regimen. So depending upon the risk of the patient, so this is the table which says about the low risk, high, intermediate risk and high risk. So in low risk patients, you can do away with the mitomycin C, but generally today all cases get mitomycin C application. Intermediate risk patient, you can use mitomycin C 0.2 milligrams per ml for 2 to 3 minutes. And in high risk patients, you can either consider a tube implant or mitomycin C can be applied about 0.4 to 0.5 milligrams per ml for about 3 to 5 minutes. So once that is done, you need to form the anterior chamber with viscoelastic. And the next step is a very crucial step where you have to cut the ostium. So the sclerostomy can be done with any sharp instrument like the Raja blade, or you can use 11 number blade, or you can even use a side port needle. The side port blade. Once a deeper dissection of the sclera is done, then we will use the Kelly sponge to cut that part of the sclera and hence complete the sclerostomy. So that's how the Kelly sponge goes inside, and in a single punch the sclera is cut. And the iris forceps is used to cut the iris forceps and vanas are used to cut the for doing the PI. Now the flap is sutured using a 10-0 nylon. So the various methods for using the sutures are the fixed sutures, the releasable sutures, the adjustable sutures. Everything depends upon the surgeon's convenience. So again, the the type of the sutures can be the various permutations and combinations can be used for that. So it could be all the three could be fixed sutures, or all the three could be releasable sutures, or in any permutation combination. And these sutures have to be buried onto the sclera to prevent the conjunctival erosion later during the postoperative life of the trabeculectomy. Then you need to form the anterior chamber well, and you need to do a watertight closure of the conjunctiva using either the Bicryl suture or the nylon suture. So conjunctiva is sutured at the limbus and it is anchored to the episclera so that the conjunctiva does not retract back. So once that is done, you need to form the bleb and check for the patency of the ostium and the extent of the bleb which is formed. So that is how a well-formed bleb looks on the table. Immediately after surgery, you can see that it is a extensive and a well-formed